Hello.
Hi. We're on the way to
Gorumba or Asli.
We used to go where no one dared to go, and now you chase.
Hello. We are on the way to the Orang Asli Museum now. My name is Michelle. This is Mani. Mani, what is it?
Hi, I'm Mani.
And this is Kasin taking the video.
Hello.
So this is the museum model and the mini theater model here, as you can see. So today we're gonna introduce to you about Orang Asli culture. So since we're in the museum, why don't you follow us? Hi. Okay. So this is the ant nest where the Orang Asli just use this for decoration only. And this is Tongkat Ali, where how you cook this is just boil it with some water, and then the Orang Asli use this for curing like any body aches or anything like that. And the rest of the stuff here are the handicraft that the Orang Asli make to earn a profit.
Alright, so can you see here? This is one of the toys for them. So they have to put this through and then slowly transfer.
That's amazing.
Thank you. So
this is the Orang Asli tribes in the Peninsula Malaysia. So for example, the Mahmeri and Cheba. And the biggest population of Orang Asli can be found in Pahang.
Okay, hi. So now we are going to bring you to the transportation part for Orang Asli. Their main transportation would be using these boats to catch fish in the lake and catch fish in the river, and a larger one for transporting passages and also forest products.
Transportation for Orang Asli, which is made up of these tree trunks, and for this one is made out of the bamboo, which Orang Asli Senoi is very expert at making it.
Okay, so this is coconut shells where they use to mash chili api on the sengkalam, and this is the sengkalam where it's just like our pasta and mortar that we use in the kitchen now. So these are the other utensils that the Orang Asli made themselves and they use in their own kitchen and their cooking. And this right here is called the gepok padi, where they use to put their pounded rice inside. So this next you will see how to make rice.
So this is the mortar food where they use it to pound rice. And there's another way to pound rice, which is this one. It's called the pounded rice mortar, and this is the pestle. The pestle is made from a type of hardwood such as meranti. And they use this to pound the hill paddy in order to separate the chaff and turn it to rice. It's like this.
This is called the Bulu Raya, which is also known as the basket trap. So this trap is placed at the banks are dams of the river so that fishes swim directly into it according to river flow.
So we will be demonstrating how they catch small animals in this. So, Jenny, makanan atau
traditional music instrument, it's gong, and over here, this is called the bajing. It's a kind of traditional music of the Orang Asli tribe, Mahmeri. So this is the pisang sesikat house of Semai tribe, and over here, this is just a normal house of Semai tribe, and over here, this is the long house of Orang Asli Tamil tribe.
entrepreneurs. They have succeeded in their careers. Like for example, in this Pelancongan tourism part, there is Mr. Kamal bin Abu Bakar, and also for fish and farming, and this cow and goat farming, and also automotive.
So all these are the famous entrepreneurs in Pahang. So this is Zulfikri bin Suhaiman. He had a manufacturing bamboo industry where Orang Asli used a lot of bamboo, so he started a business out of it. And Atong, he had a lime farm.